I care about biodiversity because every organism, however seemingly insignificant, plays a role in its ecosystem. No matter how small or how big, every organism plays a niche and contributes.
I feel like everybody should care about biodiversity. I care about it because it's the reason I'm here. It's the reason all of us are here. Without biodiversity, we wouldn't have so many amazing species. They're wondrous and beautiful to learn about.
I love biodiversity because it makes me happy. And it's kind of a funny thing to say, but when you spend a lot of time in an office or in a city, getting to walk through a park and look at trees and flowers and squirrels play and watch birds is just a great way to relax. And I feel like I need to be around living things.
What made me first excited about science was just tearing things apart. I can remember as far back as being 7 and being in my backyard and tearing flowers apart, petal by petal, leaf by leaf, and just really getting into it.
So what I enjoy most about my job is the ability to be outside. I think it's probably the reason why I chose my career as being a biologist was the opportunity to spend time out in the field. And I think that's often the most enjoyable part of my day is when I have the chance to do field work.
Well, what first made me excited about science is I have a sense of adventure. And even though I grew up in a pretty urban setting in San Francisco, I always liked parks and museums and wondered how people were able to interpret that something was from an area or a million years old. And when I began to learn more about all of the places in the world where people go to do the science, to do our science, I thought it was the most exciting field ever because you did get to get outside and go to amazing places and work with a community of scientists. It's just the routine type of work, and I thought that was really fun. Yeah.
What I love about my job is that I'm outside for most of the time. I have a tan year round. I am constantly hearing the songs of nature, of the birds, hearing the buzzing of the bees. That's my soundtrack. I have the best view in the city. It's fantastic.
So my job involves a lot of working with students in science programs. So I lead lots of educational lessons outside doing science. And I think what I enjoy most about that is that having students do these activities outside doing science, they're not only learning, but they're also learning about themselves, and they get to explore parts of themselves that they don't normally get to do in their normal lives.
I get paid to actually count birds and catch them and measure them and weigh them and just be outside, which is really awesome. And then the other side of that, you know, when we're not out in the field collecting data, is I get to figure out answers to questions that we have. So the chance to actually discover something new, which is really exciting.
I remember learning in an entomology class, an insect class, that there are millions of species of insects that are yet to be discovered. And I think that notion about science, the fact that there are things that you can't read in a book, that you can't be told about by your teacher, that there are things that you need to learn yourself and teach the world about, that was awesome.
I think as our park's aquatic ecologist, the most exciting thing for me to do is to actually be out in the field. A lot of our activities involve working with organisms that I really appreciate and care about, things like coho salmon and steelhead. And it's also really exciting to be looking for egg masses for things like red-legged frogs and tree frogs.
If I could be any species, I would be hummingbird. They're very adaptable. They've managed to survive alongside humans almost throughout the range. And they are super feisty. They have a space to themselves, and they'll kick anyone else out who doesn't belong there. They drink sugar water all day, so it's like eating candy all day, and they can fly backwards and forwards, and they're awesome and beautiful, and everybody loves hummingbirds.
Wow, so if I could be any species, what would I be and why? Well, I would probably be a type of plant, maybe because they always reach for the sun and, you know, they need a well-lit environment to grow and thrive, yet they're able to live in most any setting. To me, just speaks to their adaptability, resiliency, and yeah, ability to, I think, make an environment look even better, you know, when there's plants there, so.
School is obviously really important in becoming a scientist, but I think one really important step for me was stepping outside of my comfort zone, being willing to move away from home, try something totally new. I joined an AmeriCorps program, which actually is what brought me to California, and introduced me to a whole new set of people, whole new ideas, all different kinds of career possibilities that I didn't know about before.
I grew up in an area where I was never exposed to nature. I didn't visit a national park until I was 23 years old, and it was this national park. So I came to it very late in the game, and it's never too late. Even if you feel like there's no nature around where you live, it can find you anywhere, and you're never gonna go back once you find it.